And on the state scene, the Premier says she expects more of her team to quit before the state election, 8 months away.
The resignation of Labor heavyweight John Della Bosca has sparked new speculation about who else might jump ship or even get pushed.
Having resigned to the Governor, John Della Bosca's the latest Labor MP to make an exit, but not without one final hurdle.
Into occupational and safety trouble one day.
I've made some mistakes, but I think I've, on balance, put in a pretty good effort, and it's time to leave it to someone else now.
He was caught up in an ugly argument with staff at the now infamous Iguanas Bar on the Central Coast, then scorned lover Kate Neal exposed their six-month affair.
There's a reason for that. You have to make decisions. Sometimes you make enemies, make opponents, you upset people, things go wrong.
He's looking forward to his new job in disabilities and admits the party needs to focus on renewal. Even the Premier's expecting this departure won't be the last.
People make decisions about whether or not to continue in their parliamentary career. It's not surprising. I anticipate there will be more decisions.
But many of the MPs considered publicly problematic are vowing to stay on, like controversial power broker Joe Tripodi. Eddie Obeid's term in the upper house won't expire until 2015. Minister Frank Sartor's contemplating his future. Then there's Matt Brown, who was sacked for dancing in his underwear, and Tony Stewart, who was also sacked from the ministry but intends to stay on.
I don't think they're capable of rejuvenating at this stage. I think it's time for a change.
The extent of that change for the Premier will be fought out during a pre-selection battle that will get underway after the federal poll. Josh Murphy, 10 News.